The Document Strategy Podcast is brought to you by Audible.com. Visit audibletrial.com/document for a free audiobook download and a free trial membership. Choose from over 150,000 audiobooks. Get your free download at audibletrial.com/document. Welcome to the Document Strategy Podcast, reaching worldwide to talk to thought leaders, innovators, and subject matter experts to explore communication strategies that break new ground in business performance. I'm your host, Kevin Crane. Welcome to the show. I've got two great guests with me today, including Brad Banyas, founder and CEO of OMI and an expert in Cloud CCM, or Cloud-Based Customer Communications Management. What is Cloud CCM and how can it help connect more effectively with customers? We'll find out in just a few minutes. But first, I have a special report with industry expert and reporter Pat McGrew, coming to us live and direct from the Exploration 14 conference currently being held in Orlando, Florida, March 2014. The Explore conference mixes education with networking in a relaxing environment like sunny Orlando. So let's find out what's going on from the show floor in Orlando. Pat McGrew, welcome to the broadcast. What's your impression so far?
I have to tell you that Explore has gone through its ups and downs over the years. Very excited this year. We've been sort of surveying in the sessions, asking how many people have been coming to Explore, more than 20 years, quite a few hands go up, more than 10 years, more than 5 years, or less than 5 years. And we're really pleased that about half of the people who are raising their hand are in the under 5 year category. And that's really good news for us because that means that we're once again doing our job and reaching out into the industry and finding the people who need to be educated, want to be educated, and want to share what they know. And of course at Explore, we like to be all about the sharing. We have had some amazing sessions on color management and workflow and compliance and regulation. This is one-stop shopping, which is kind of cool.
I'm speaking with Pat McGrew. She's reporting to us live from the Exploration 14 conference, currently being held in Orlando, Florida. It's time for a quick break, but when we get back, I'll ask Pat more about the Explore conference and some of the awards being given out this year. So stick around. We'll be right back. Since 1995, Crawford Technologies has been the driving force behind high-volume transactional customer communications for many of the world's top organizations, and their solutions are the products of choice for corporations and service bureaus around the globe. Their Riptide product just won an award at today's Exploration 14 conference, so why not check them out? Visit CrawfordTech.com for more information. That's CrawfordTech.com. Award-winning software for high-volume transactional customer communications.
You're listening to the Document Strategy Podcast.
Welcome back. I'm speaking with Pat McGrew. She's reporting to us live from the Exploration 14 conference, currently being held in Orlando, Florida. Pat, the Explore conference has been retooled a bit and rebranded this year to be known as the Exploration 14 conference. What is the reason behind that retooling and rebranding, and how do you think it's going?
I think that we're doing, it's the first step in what I think will be a series of steps towards reinvigorating the brand of Explore. The whole concept here was to take a name, a moniker that we could use reliably year on year and build some name recognition. About 5 years ago, Explore made the decision to come back to a dedicated conference to basically serve our constituency the way we needed to, but we sort of struggled every year to come up, what do we call this thing this year? Is it this? Is it that? So the decision was taken that we will now be the Exploration Conference. It allows us to do a couple of things. It means that we can grow the subject matter that we cover, transaction billing documents, but also direct mail marketing, any place where variable data and variable content is part of the story. We can rope that into our curriculum, and it still lets us serve our core constituency. So we're pretty excited. There will be Exploration 15.
I'm speaking with Pat McGrew, reporting to us live from the Exploration Conference in Orlando, Florida. There are several industry awards you were just at the session, Pat, that are being given out this year. And when we get back, I'm going to ask Pat about those awards and find out which technologies and which providers are being honored this year. So stick around. We'll be right back with this episode of the Document Strategy Podcast. Do you have great ideas but need expert writing skills to make them leap from the page? Do you have a great product or service that needs better exposure to new customers, potential partners, or the media? Crane Communications Group is a strategic communications agency focused on the document management and customer communications industries. There is no other writing and communications agency with more expertise in the industry. Find out more today at cranegroup.com. That's C-R-A-I-N-E, cranegroup.com.
You're listening to the Document Strategy Podcast.
Welcome back. I'm with Pat McGrew, who is reporting to us live from the floor of the Exploration 14 Conference, currently being held in Orlando, Florida. The Exploration Conference is a three-day industry event focused on document processing and customer communications. Pat, several industry awards are being given out this year at Explore. Can you tell me a bit about that? Who won and for what?
So the awards this year were an interesting mix of sort of the usual suspects and some new award winners, which was really kind of interesting. It says to us that the awards are being taken seriously and that more people are looking to be recognized. The Technology of the Year Award was given to Crawford Technology's Riptide product. Riptide is a really nice package that gives you a lot of output management functionality, but the real big thing is that it allows you to assemble enterprise content management repository data into something that is more usable from a business perspective. There were honorable mentions in that category, too. The OSE ColorStream 3000 inkjet presses were an honorable mention, and the HP Extreme HP Relate tool was also an honorable mention in that category. Chairman's Award went to Ryerson University in Toronto, which is, if you're kind of in the industry, you may know a Ryerson graduate. They have an amazing print program, kind of very similar to the RIT program in Rochester. Ryerson was honored for their longstanding support of Explore, but also for producing a lot of really great print professionals. And the other thing that Randy pointed out when he was making the award is that Ryerson has now an Explore chapter, a student Explore chapter. So we were kind of excited about that. There were two Brian Plenty Lifetime Awards winners. They are Mal Balboyan, who is, if you know the OSE Canon story, he's been the president of Production Printing Systems of down here in Boca for a long time. And, we were delighted to give him that award. And then also Harry Lewis, who is, of course, the president of the AAC Consortium, was the other winner of the Brian Plenty Lifetime Achievement Award. So it was just a full house, and it was a party.
Pat, I know your time is limited. I know you've got to run to keep up with your heavy schedule at Explore, meeting with folks and conducting presentations, attending sessions. So I want to thank you for reporting to us live from the Exploration 14 conference. I'm sure we'll be back in touch with you again. But until then, thanks again and travel safe.
Thanks. It's always my pleasure.
That's Pat McGrew reporting to us live from the Exploration 14 conference. Next up, Brad Banyas, an expert in Cloud CCM, or cloud-based customer communications management. Brad says Cloud CCM is the next big thing in cloud computing. We'll find out more after this. This episode of the Document Strategy Podcast is sponsored in part by Crawford Technologies. Their ECM output management solution, Riptide, just won the Technology of the Year Award at Exploration 14. Riptide provides the ability to output content from different and disparate enterprise content management repositories and deliver those documents for output in print, fax, email, PDF, and more. Find out more at CrawfordTech.com. That's Crawford, T-E-C-H.com. Document-strategy.com. That's where you'll find everything you need to design a document strategy that makes sense. including my book, Designing a Document Strategy, now available in both print and ebook format, and my 3-hour document strategy training DVD. Just go to document-strategy.com and check it out. That's document-strategy.com, your real-world resource for document strategy design.
You're listening to the Document Strategy Podcast.
Welcome back. I'm with Brad Banyas, founder and president of OMI and an expert in cloud-based customer communications management, or Cloud CCM. Brad, welcome to the program. What is Cloud CCM?
Cloud CCM stemmed from the term customer communication management. The original concept had to do more with, you know, managing messaging on your outbound communications, your statements, your bills, insurance policies. But today, you know, Cloud CCM is really kind of an extension of those communications to your existing customer base and potentially, you know, prospective customer bases. And so the world is trying to move to where you can engage with your end customers really anywhere and everywhere. So Cloud CCM allows you to take, you know, context and content that traditionally might have gone in a printed piece and be able to deliver that where your customers are going to engage, either through an online customer-facing portal where they're coming to, you know, renew or pay bills, to email, to social media, and even more so moving now to mobile to be able to push relative context and content to users that are on mobile applications or consuming it via mobile.
We're going to take a short break, but when we get back, I'm going to ask Brad, why should companies be looking at Cloud CCM, and how can companies take advantage of Cloud CCM to not only gain new customers, but also build a better and more profitable relationship with existing customers? So stick around. We'll be right back with this episode of the Document Strategy Podcast. Welcome back. I'm with Brad Banyas, expert at Cloud Customer Communications Management, Cloud CCM. Brad, why should companies be looking at Cloud CCM?
It's evident to those who have been in the market, Kevin, but it's not so evident to the corporations, because traditionally, operational or outbound correspondence that's been going to existing customers has not really made it into the CMO or the marketing board. They've been more focused on new lead acquisition or new technologies like marketing automation. Obviously, you know, CRM plays in that role. So what Cloud CCCM is allowing these organizations to do is really get a better view of their customers and how they're engaging. So if from a sales side or marketing side, or really even a customer service side, they have one place where aggregated, you know, communications, whether they were outbound or inbound, like on a marketing campaign, are there for viewing and analyzing, you know, what kind of content is resonating with their customers, what their interests are. So advertising today is very expensive. The cost to, you know, get a new customer can be anywhere from 6 to, you know, 12 times what it is to retain an existing customer. What Cloud CCCM does is really make the activities and engagements around communications visible to both marketing, operations, and sales, thus allowing you to really target and personalize. So it lowers your cost of marketing and sales to your existing customers by really giving true visibility. Where today, those, you know, customer profiles are typically siloed. They're in a CRM, they're in an ERP. So the operational and the marketing side communications have never really melded. So Cloud CCCM really acts kind of as a destination service to allow that true visual experience for the brand to really truly measure and target their existing customer base.
You mentioned that it costs more to acquire a new customer than it does to sell additional products and services to an existing one. It seems ironic that companies spend millions of dollars to create beautiful marketing campaigns for the purpose of acquiring new customers, but don't always spend that attention or money on managing the customer experience or the brand experience once they become customers. How can companies use Cloud CCM to better manage that customer experience?
I think it's kind of a change management ideology. many marketing automation efforts, which is the hot technology today, is automating marketing, which goes back to, you know, why companies are actually investing a lot in marketing automation tools is because it does lower their cost of sale. It automates processes that traditionally would have taken a human or sales to intervene and manage the process. So very much like that from a cloud CCM perspective is it basically allows a better view and a better execution of operational marketing communication. So cloud CCM is really helping companies understand and be able to automate any kind of targeted message or targeted offer, or really, you know, get closer to the customer at the time that they're looking for something. So I'll give you an example. If I'm sending consistent messages and communications out across all of my channels, you know, print, maybe some dynamic messaging or white space messaging, as well as taking that same content and context that I've kind of targeted my customer base with and offering that wherever they engage with me, online or actually in a portal or via an email, the rate of frequency of that message, and if it's targeted correctly and the content is right, your chances are better to, you know, engage that customer and turn them into a repeat buyer. And whether that's very relative in the retail world today in commerce, but it's not so obvious in traditional businesses, whether you're in manufacturing or insurance or financial services. So we're trying to bring that same concept, if you will, of how retail does it today to everyday businesses.
I'm speaking with Brad Banyas, founder and CEO of OMI and an expert in cloud-based customer communications. We're going to take another quick break, but when we get back, I'm going to ask Brad about a specific model that he prescribes for ensuring ROI with cloud CCM. So stick around. We'll be right back with this episode of the Document Strategy Podcast. Do you have great ideas but need expert writing skills to make them leap from the page? Do you have a great product or service that needs better exposure to new customers, potential partners, or the media? Crane Communications Group is a strategic communications agency focused on the document management and customer communications industries. Expert writing and editing, audio success stories and custom podcasts, and dependable and professional industry-focused expertise and service. There is no other writing and communications agency with more expertise in the industry. Find out more today at cranegroup.com. That's C-R-A-I-N-E, cranegroup.com.
You're listening to the Document Strategy Podcast.
Welcome back. I'm with Brad Banyas, and we're talking about Cloud CCM, or Cloud Customer Communications Management. Brad, you talk about a specific model that you folks use at OMI for ensuring or gaining ROI with cloud CCM. Can you explain what that model is and how it works?
Our model that we created is called CARE. And CARE basically makes up five components. Those areas are consumption, adoption, retention, revenue creation, and measuring engagement. The CARE model was really stemmed from an idea about consumption economics. And most technology companies today in the cloud have to measure or drive consumption, adoption, retention, and engagement in order to survive, because most of their revenue is generated off of transactions or, you know, end customers consuming, you know, their services, or they don't survive. So the CARE model, if you look at it from a customer communications management perspective, is applied to obviously what content or what messaging are your customers consuming. You know, are they adopting to new services or things that you're trying to actually offer to them? And then as far as retention, how are existing customers, what are you doing to retain them? Are you basically targeting them messages that are relevant to them? And then we move really more into the revenue creation side is, you know, how do you turn these customers, say, in a financial services vertical where they might have a checking account or a statement account, how do you offer higher related services, maybe home equity lines or car loans or different type of financial services? The cloud communication model allows you to really target segment and see which messages are they're resonating and see if they actually convert that offer into a loan. And we track that through the process through the Cloud CCCM and CARE model. And then final is engagement. Since we're monitoring and measuring things about outbound messaging and inbound messaging, and when someone comes into a portal, say to renew a policy in an insurance world, we know where they're engaging and what information they're engaging on. So we literally can track across the different channels how that customer engaged. If they are, we actually provide engagement ratings, you know, are they highly engaged, are they moderately engaged, or are they not engaged? And then if they're not engaged, you have to be able to redefine your messages across those channels where they were interact to try to re-engage them, whether it's an offer or a promotion or simply just a reach out to see how they're doing.
Brad, I know that you and others say that Cloud CCM is the next big thing in cloud computing. So my next question is, you know, that sounds great, but how do I do it? At OMI, you have developed a cloud CCM platform called 366 Degrees that is a system that helps companies manage all of their customer communications. Can you tell us a little bit more about how 366 Degrees works?
What people may or may not know about OMI, we've actually been in a software as a service model since our inception, which was 1999. So from that perspective, we have a lot of experience. So 366 Degrees has grown out of some previous offers that we had. And what 366 Degrees does is I look at it very much like Box, what Box did for file sharing and document exchange, where in the past you had all these different systems where you were emailing documents. And then now, you know, you can basically aggregate, share information around documents and files. If you think of that same Box model, what 366 Degrees does is allows those parties that are managing communications on behalf of the brand to put 366 Degrees as a destination service. So allows the brand to really see a good visualization of what those communications were and where their customers are engaging with them at.
I've been speaking with Brad Banyas, founder and CEO of OMI and an expert in customer communications management. Brad, where can people go to find out more about Cloud CCM and about what you folks are doing at OMI?
If someone wants to find out more, you know, what we're doing in that area, they can visit us certainly at OMI.co, where we have more information on 366 Degrees and some of the services that we provide in the cloud. So that's a good place to start. It's relatively new to the software providers and even the actual print providers and the .com. So it's a new market. It's a new area that's bringing all these other traditional disparate, you know, marketing avenues into one, you know, one platform. But I think you have to understand, you know, where you're going to integrate into these ERP systems like SAP or IBM or Oracle, as well as, you know, leading CRMs, you know, NetSuite, Salesforce.com. So it requires a very unique expertise. So as people go out to evaluate Cloud CCCM, it typically they're trying to compartmentalize it to a document composition software package, or an email marketing, or a social media platform. It can't be really siloed. There's really rarely ever one tool that's delivering all these capabilities, because the customers either are doing that internally or outsourcing it. So the cloud is a great aggregation model, and we look forward to answering any questions someone may have about that.
That's Brad Banyas, founder and CEO of OMI and an expert in customer communications management. You can find him at omi.co. Brad, thanks a lot for being a guest on the show today.
Oh, Kevin, thank you very much. It's always a pleasure. Enjoyed it.
That'll do it for this episode of the Document Strategy Podcast. If you'd like to reach us on the show, it's easy. Just go to document-strategy.com. We welcome your feedback and suggestions for topics and guests for the show. Maybe you'd like to be a guest, or you'd like to be a sponsor. We'd love to hear from you. If you like what we're doing, please leave a review on iTunes. We appreciate your help in spreading the word about this show. Meanwhile, join us next time when we continue to explore methods, technologies, and techniques that break new ground in business performance. I'm your host, Kevin Crane. Thanks for listening.